Hey guys, what's going on? It's Don here from Nova Spirit Tech, and as you all know, on 3/14, which is Pi Day, Raspberry Pi decided to release an upgraded version of the Raspberry Pi 3 called the B Plus, or Raspberry Pi 3 B Plus, and that's what we're going to be talking about, so let's get started. Alright, so if you guys have already been doing a lot of research and you know all about the new specs, you could probably skip a little bit to the overclocking bits, but for those who are just hearing about this now, let's check this guy out. So, to begin, you've got a slightly upgraded CPU, which they didn't really upgrade in model number, but they just upgraded in like, they changed the model number a little bit. But what they did add is the aluminum heatsink that goes on top, and they clocked it at 1.4 now. The second thing that they added is Wi-Fi. So now it could do 2.4 and 5 gigahertz, and also a slight little increase in speed. The big thing that they did upgrade is the Gigabit LAN that runs over USB 2 controller. Now, why I mentioned it's running over the USB 2.0 controller, it means that it's still not true Gigabit LAN Ethernet. It's about 300 megabytes. It's just the same as if you were to use a USB connector, you know, the USB Ethernet connector and plug it in. Another thing they added was PoE, which is power over Ethernet. You could actually now power this through the Ethernet, and they have these new 4-pin plugs, and you need to get an official hat that actually goes on top of that for that to work. Obviously, this has a network boot dip, but they actually fixed it and improved it, so which is good. And really, honestly, I should do a video on the Pi server because I think it's something I should dabble on. Now, one thing they didn't upgrade, which I wish they did, was the RAM. It still stays the same as one gigabyte. One thing most notable that a lot of people forget to mention or don't mention because I saw a couple of reviews is that it's actually now running on a PMIC, which is a power controller. Now, I found that to be the most interesting part of this build is because that means it's possible for me to control the voltage to the CPU through this PMIC. I don't know yet because I looked at the kernel and I did some grepping. I didn't find anything related to 7705, which is the model number for this PMIC, but wishful thinking. I'm hoping I could do something with that. Well, all those upgrades, and it's still exactly the same price, $35. So with all that out of the way, let's see how fast I could actually overclock this. I was able to actually get it up to 1.6 gigahertz. It was able to boot up and do some light tasks, but then again, it started to freeze. So I had to downclock it to 5.8 gigahertz and it was stable at 5.8. Now here's the thing, thermal ratings is completely different on this guy. Once it hits 70 degrees Celsius, it will automatically downclock it back to 1.2. Not 1.4 where it's supposed to be stock clock, 1.2, which is the previous through Raspberry Pi 3 clock. And obviously when it cools under 70 degrees, it'll bump it back up to where it's supposed to be. I ran this guy without a heatsink and it worked really good. It actually kept the temps really low. And if I was to put a heatsink on there, I bet you it'll do wonders. As far as network speeds, I was saying earlier, it's about 300 megabytes using IP perf. And so far as it stands, this is a really good upgrade, especially for the price, which is the same as the previous one. And you're getting all this speed. I know you guys are probably thinking about how much faster am I gonna get with mining. I'll probably do a video on that a little bit later once I get this to be stable and played around with it a little bit more. So that's it for me, guys. If you guys enjoyed this video, please hit that like button. If you guys got any questions about this or want to see some things happen or want me to do something or test something, hit up in the comments below. If you guys are new to this channel, consider subscribing and also hitting that bell notification icon so you know when the next video is going to be out. And as I say in my nerd cave, hack till it hurts.